This is a demonstration of the SmartDraft View Tools. This video will demonstrate the SmartDraft View Tools, View, Crosshairs, Viewport, Viewport Move panels on the SD View ribbon. The first command that we will demonstrate is View Twist. VT is the command alias. This command allows you to twist the view of a drawing using two points, and those two points become the new horizontal. The north is adjusted per that twist, and the coordinates of the line work is not changed. You'll also notice that the crosshairs have been made parallel to the bottom of the screen. If at some later time you would like to have north point directly up, you could use the view twist zero or V0 command to rotate the drawing back to north, pointing directly up. The view twist command is also very useful when rotating views for layout. So if we change to the layout view, we can set our horizontal scale, rotate this view to make this road viewable within our window. Another very useful command is the view save all, or VSA command. This command saves views to predetermined names depending on if you're in model space, on a layout tab, if you're in the layout view, or in the various viewports within a layout. I would say we're going to save this view. And then now, if I was to zoom in accidentally, I could restore that view back to what it was. Same would be if on layout. I could view save all. If I was to zoom in, view all, and restore that. And that would also be the same in model space. Other very useful commands would be manipulating the crosshairs if you were in a view twist scenario. So if we had this drawing twisted and you wanted to get the crosshairs back to zero, just select crosshairs to zero, and now the crosshairs are pointing to north. If you wanted them now back parallel to the view twist, just say crosshairs horizontal to screen. The command alias for crosshairs horizontal to screen is UV, and UW crosshairs to zero. Another very useful tool for manipulating the angle of the crosshairs is the crosshairs aligned to an object, UO. This way I could select an object, straight segment in the drawing. Crosshairs are rotated to that angle. If I have ortho turned on, now I can very easily create an object that is parallel and perpendicular to that snapped angle. And then again, take my crosshairs and move them back. Let's change to a different drawing and demonstrate the viewport and the viewport move commands. The first one is make viewport, VPM. This command allows you to create a viewport from a selected area. So if we were to zoom in to, say again, this road, I could either twist it to the way I want to, or you'll see us being able to actually create the view and then twist the view. I would say make view. The ratio that it's going to use is the horizontal scale. So if I did R, I could set the horizontal scale that I want it to be. So now when I actually pick something, it's going to show it at 40 scale. Pick a point. I'll use an O-snap near to pick a point actually on this alignment. I could type in some dimensions, 1,000 by 400. Move to that center point. Twist from the center point to that. If I didn't like those dimensions, I could change that. And then when done, say end, it switches to a layout, pick a point, and now that rectangular view that I specified in model space is the viewport created in the layout. Also, you could go the other direction using the viewport zoom. So if I was to set your horizontal scale on a viewport, even if it's not the way I would like, say viewport zoom, select that viewport window because I know what size of the window I'm going to use. You can see that it's going to create a rectangle in model space the size that that viewport is for the scale factor selected. Select a point. Again, I can do changing the horizontal scale. I can twist it. I can move it around. Once I like it, I say end, and you can see that it zoomed to that area that I specified. The next command is the viewport divide. This would allow you to divide a viewport either vertically or horizontally, and the viewport, two pieces of viewport, are still going to show the same data inside. This is very useful if you're working with profile views and maybe the slope of the profile was so steep you had to actually divide it and then shift one side up. So here we go with divide, select our profile view. It snaps to the lower left corner. If I pick a point up, it will divide it horizontally. If I pick a point to the right along the bottom, it will divide it vertically. So you can see wherever I selected, now we actually have two viewports taking up the same space as a previous viewport, but showing the same information. How that is very useful is, now we could use these other commands, view move, which allows you to move the data inside a viewport, either up, down, horizontally, vertically. Then there are some preset ones, move up one unit, move up 5 units, move down 5 units, move down 1 unit. Let's say move up 5 units, you'll notice that it read the horizontal scale, 40, and it's assuming a vertical scale of 1/10. You can go in there and change that to say 1/8 or 1/4, and you see what the interval is. Now when I select the viewport frame, it actually shifted that particular view 5 units up. If you wanted to move it 5 units back down, you could do so. Go back up. Or even one at a time if I pick it multiple times. Now it's at 6, 7, 8. Or if I was to come in here and have a, you know, do something, oh, now I have a problem. And now how do I get these to line up again? I come back out into the layout. I can use this viewport align command, select the one that's still correct, select another viewport, and now it's back lined up. I can use this to move it up 5 units. Here's a more extreme example where you have 4 viewports right next to each other. Here's our source. We want to align them all, which will set them all to the same viewport scale, rotate them all the same angle, and then also line them up. So I'll select the source, and I can use a window to select all the others, put them all the same viewport scale, set them all to the same rotation angle, and then line them up so that they look like they are actually tiled together. This concludes the demonstration of the SmartDraft view tools. Thank you.